You might be wondering, why build an MP3 player? Smartphones can do much better than this. With all those apps and streaming services, you don't even need to download any music or song. But this module really excited me with a bunch of features, from a volume control, a 3-watt amplifier, equalizer, and much more. I wanted to explore all these features and put it to a good use in a single device. So this MP3 player was a perfect choice to test all this. And also, by building the user interface, I had a great time using the UAG2 library, which in the past, I hardly used it once or twice. Also, I built a small Python application with help of one of my friends. This application should help you transfer the files easily from your system to DF player without any hassle of renaming the files and folders. If you guys have any better suggestions to use the DF player, you can comment it below. If it's interesting, I'll definitely give it a try. Now without any further delay, let's get started. Let's take a quick dive into the device. It supports a microSD, a 3.5mm audio jack, 3 button navigation, pretty cool retro looking UI on the 1.3 inch OLED screen, and finally an Arduino Pro Mini controlling the display, taking user input and playing the audio files from the DF player. Before going on, if you haven't watched the first part of this video, I highly recommend you watch that first before watching this. In order to start the build, let's go with one step at a time. First, let's see how to use a 1.3 inch OLED display with an Arduino Nano. This has 4 pins, VCC, ground, SDA and SCL. Just connect the VCC and ground to +5V and ground of the Arduino. And connect the SDA and SCL to A4 and A5 of the Arduino Nano. 1.3 inch OLED and 0.96 inch OLED may look similar, but they don't share the same display driver. So if you try to use a library like Adafruit SSD1306, the display won't work, because the 1.3 inch OLED display has a SH1106 display driver. So we are going to use the UAG2 library. Go to your library manager and install the latest version. UAG2 library has a lot of flexibility when compared to other libraries. For example, you can run the same code for a variety of display with very minimal code change. And importantly, gives you a wide range of fonts and open icons to use in your project. If I have to implement all this in other libraries, it would have been pretty hard trying to find these icons and make the UI. Now, to test the display, you can either run the demo sketch, which comes with the UAG2 library, or you can compile and run my sketch from GitHub. The link for that will be given in the description. Once you have done that, the display should work without any problem. I'll skip the part about using the DF player, because we have seen in previous 2 videos how to use the DF player to build a hand wash dispenser, as well as how to get started with DF player. Now, we can start with the build. You can see this might look messy, and you may think it would be way better to do it in a PCB. I totally agree, but this is comparatively more fun, and personally, they are pretty cool to look at as well. And this is also like a brain teaser where you have to start thinking 5 to 6 steps in advance before placing and soldering the components, because once you solder it, it gets really messy correcting it. Since I wanted to use the components on both the sides, I bought a 2-sided PCB and cut it such a way that horizontally it has 14 holes and vertically 21. Then place the push button, which will help us in navigation, pause and play of the song. Finally, solder them to the bottom of the PCB. Now when you want to place other components, you need to be really careful where you place them and how many pins each component has. But my advice is to keep only the pins that I use and cut the rest of them. You can refer to the circuit diagram to do so. The link will be given in the description. I placed the digital pin of the Arduino close to the buttons and soldered them to their respective pins. I did follow the same process for the DF player, but I removed the black separator so the DF player has a proper fit in the board along with the Arduino. I wanted to run DF player with full capacity, So I added a small boost converter to convert the 3.7 volt from the lithium battery to 5 volt. But in the end, this module couldn't provide enough current to run the DF player, and I felt it was doing much better with 3.7 volt battery alone. So in the end, I discarded the boost converter. Then we'll install the slide switch and the 3.5 mm audio jack. We'll use this switch for power on and power off. And this audio jack should be pretty much be fine for most of the headphones. The next point to remember is to solder the components close to each other, where you can merge two connections easily, and try to avoid multi-strand wires. Instead, use the bare single strand wire to make the connections and make sure you don't touch any of the components on the bottom side too. Now place the TP4056 module, which we'll be using to charge our MP3 player with micro USB. I use double-sided tape to place the lithium polymer battery next to the charging module. This is a 300 mAh battery which fits perfectly within the PCB. If you build a bigger one, you can easily expand the battery without any modification to the current circuit. Finally, solder the OLED display to finish it off. If you could follow the circuit diagram and place the components in the same order, it will be a lot easier to work with. Then I gave some final touch by giving it some smooth rounded corners, and I drilled a hole at the top corner so I can use this as a keychain. Now we can look into the programming part. First, install the necessary libraries. Start with dfrobot dfplayer-mini.h for controlling the DF player. Go to Sketch, Include Library, and install this library. Then the rest of the libraries come with the Arduino IDE. These are used to initialize for I2C, SoftUART, and storing data on EEPROM. Make sure you don't change the button pins, because they use the external interrupt to take the input from the user. The code also features number of files and number of folders, but unfortunately, I think I have a knockoff version of the DF player. The DF player doesn't even query the number of folders and number of files from the SD card. In case you have the original DF player, you can use this and print it on the OLED screen. If you go to the next file, you can see there is an option to read battery value, but I have not included it in the final version because of too much information on the screen. In the next file, you can see I have written the interrupt function, which works fine but written in a terrible way, and it's pretty easy to fix, so I will leave it up to you. And finally, in the last program file, you can change the way the UI looks on the OLED screen. This is a bunch of UAG2 library function to draw text and icons. You can fiddle around here to suit your needs. Once you are sure that you have installed all the required libraries, you can compile and upload the code. While this is compiling and uploading, if you guys have seen this video this far, a subscription would be greatly appreciated. It will really help me build a much better project. You can see the Arduino boots up and the OLED screen works. Before jumping in and seeing all the features of the MP3 module, let's copy some music files. For this, you have to follow some certain naming convention, even though it would work fine without it. So to make everything simple, I have a Python script in the GitHub repo, along with the code for the project. Just run the script in the command prompt and you should get a GUI interface where you can transfer files to your SD card hassle-free for your DF player. Here you can create as many folders as you want, and you can add as many files as you need in the file list. You can also remove unwanted folders and files. The program looks like it's from past decade, so it matches our MP3 player vibe. Insert the SD card and turn on the sound pod. You can navigate using the left and right button, while the middle button acts as select. From the code, you would have figured out that it stores volume, EQ, and file numbers in the EEPROM. So even when you turn off and turn on, all your settings are saved. In the player screen, you have the pause, play, next, and previous options, along with the number of tracks you played. In the settings screen, you have the volume control and the EQ adjustment. You can see the DF player datasheet to see what each number does for the EQ. Let me play some music and show you how amazing it sounds, even though it sounds a bit noisy because of the wiring and the soldering which I have done. If you have been following me on Instagram or if you have gone through the GitHub commits, you would have seen a different iteration of this UI. And other features I wanted to add to this MP3 player. But the amount of RAM and the flash memory of the Arduino puts a limit to this. Since it's in U8G2 library, it should be fairly easy to change the display and build a different version of this MP3 player. And there was a great idea from one of the viewers to make two of this using ESP and try to sync up the audio playback on both of the device, just like the SoundSeeder app, which is doable once you swap out the Pro Mini with ESP. So if you guys try any of this or have any other ideas, I would love to hear it from you. Just comment below. Just a reminder again, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, it would be great if you could do it now and allow notification to get notified when I upload a new video. If you think any of your friends might enjoy this content, don't hesitate to share this video. And finally, to keep up with the upcoming projects, you can follow me on Instagram. You can also support me on Patreon to help me build more amazing projects. And finally, you can watch the other exciting videos from the link on the screen or just go to my channel.